Hello everyone, I'm Utsav Raghuvanshi. I'm a program manager with Azure Backup. And today we're gonna talk about what's new with Azure Backup. Now I'm pretty sure everyone watching this session is already familiar with what Azure Backup is, but just a quick recap. Azure Backup is a fully managed service that is built entirely in Azure and that lets you backup your workloads, both in the cloud as well as on premises. Now, what really differentiates Azure Backup is that it does not require you to set up any infrastructure like servers or storage. And this makes it really simple to use, and it also lowers your cost of ownership. Now, all of Azure Backup's philosophy revolves around three core pillars of providing diverse mission-critical workload support, secure and resilient data protection, and simple and cost-effective management. Now, let me give you a quick sneak peek into how we do this. Backup integrates natively into various workloads of yours that run in Azure, like Azure virtual machines, databases like SQL Server and SAP HANA running inside these virtual machines, as well as Azure files. This is why you do not need to write any scripts or provision any infrastructure to get started. Backup also uses the highly reliable and available Azure Blob Storage to store your backups. Apart from various capabilities already provided by Blob Storage, Backup also provides its own set of features in the form of various security features like role-based access control, encryption options, soft delete, you have various access tiers, and you have various redundancy options for your backups like LRS, GRS, and RAGRS. Also, you don't need to worry about cleaning up your older recovery points. Backup does it for you. Backup also seamlessly scales with your growing data assets and backup assets. Also, you have various automation options at your disposal, like PowerShell, CLI, you have ARM templates, and REST APIs. Backup also leverages various core Azure infrastructure management technologies, like Azure Policy, Resource Graph, Monitor, and Lighthouse. So you don't have to adopt a new strategy for thinking about your backup management. Backup also provides various tools like Backup Explorer and reports that help you analyze your backup usage. With this versatile architecture, Backup provides you a simple, secure, and cost-effective solution to meet all your backup needs. Now, let's have a look at what's new with Azure Backup. First and foremost, we add a new workload to the list. Today, we're excited to announce the public preview for PostgreSQL Server Backup. With this, you can perform long-term retention of your backups till up to 10 years. Also, this allows to manage your operations at the database level, so you have much more granular control over what you want to backup and for how long you want to retain it. Also, you get to restore your databases across different versions, which might well be the case if you're choosing to perform a restore several years down the line. Also, all your backups are retained in a different fault domain, which means if in a corner case of something happening to your servers, your source servers that is, your backups still remain intact. Do check out the link at the bottom of the page for more details on this. So very happy to inform you about another workload that we're adding to the list in the coming month. This is the Azure Blob Storage, and we have an operational backup solution for it coming up in October. The operational backup for Azure Blob Storage allows you to retain backups of your Azure Blobs in the source storage account itself. And this gives you protection against various data loss scenarios like deletion and overwrites of blobs, accidental deletions of storage accounts, as well as tampering with the data protection settings of the storage account. You also get various management options that allow you to manage Azure blobs and the protection at scale across different storage accounts. Once again, I would urge you to check out the link at the bottom of the page to know more about what this solution has to offer. New workloads is not all that's new. We have some great enhancements for our existing workloads as well. Starting with Azure VMs, you now have selective disk backups that allow you to get much more granular control over what you want to backup. We have extended the support to various new configurations of virtual machines as well, such as virtual machine scale sets, as well as virtual machines having larger disks, as well as virtual machines having large number of disks, that is up to 32 disks. Backup also provides a new app consistency framework for virtual machines that run big databases like Oracle and MySQL in Linux VMs. And you can use an app consistency snapshot for backing these up now. We have some restore enhancements as well. For example, you can now restore your unmanaged disks as managed disks. Coming to databases, today we're excited to announce the public preview for cross-region restore of SQL and SAP HANA databases. This ensures that your backups are available and recoverable at all times. SAP HANA databases running on RHEL machines are also now supported. Also, something to look out for in the next month is the private preview for incremental backups. SQL Server also has some notable improvements, such as SQL Server Backup now supports backup of databases over 2 TBs. You also have improved speeds of backup for all databases of all sizes for SQL. Azure Files also has its shares of enhancements, such as integration into the Azure Files UI, and all protected file shares now have protection against accidental deletions. Azure Files Backup also has a new backup policy, which uses a grandfather-father-son scheme for specifying retention, as well as a new flat and cost-effective pricing model. So moving from workloads onto security, this incredibly important pillar that when it comes to backup also has some notable improvements. Starting off with resiliency, we're excited to announce the public preview for zone redundant backup storage. This allows you to get improved availability of your data without even having to move out of the region. We also have some security updates, like in addition to support of private endpoints for backup and encryption of backup data using customer managed keys, we are also now excited to announce the limited public preview for multi-user authentication. Now let's take a look at how backup can help you manage your ever-growing and vast data sources. As your data assets and backup assets continue to grow, you'll see that they spread across different vaults, different subscriptions, different regions, and at times even different tenants. And at times like these, you have questions like, how do I ensure that all my data sources that deserve to be backed up are being backed up and they're being backed up correctly? How do I know if everything is going on as it should be going on and if there's something that needs my attention? Also, how do you know how your usage is faring? Is there a way to optimize your usage? Therefore, your importance of governance, monitoring and operating and gathering insight, it increases exponentially as your backup assets continue to grow. And today, we're excited to announce the public preview for Backup Center. Now, Backup Center is your single pane of glass that can help you achieve all of this and a lot more. In order to get started with Backup Center, all you need to do is just type Backup Center in the Azure portal search bar, and you'll see the Backup Center icon pop up. Just click on it, and here you are. Now, I know I've talked about it already, how Backup Center is that single pane of glass that you need, and this is what I mean when I say that. Right now, I can manage all the data sources and all the backup instances across my 450 vaults that are spread across 37 subscriptions. And not only that, also across 63 locations. And if I'm using my Lighthouse account, I can actually get my backup details across different subscriptions as well. Now, right now I have chosen Azure Virtual Machines as my data source type, but you can go ahead and choose whichever data source type you want more details for. One of the first things you'll notice when you land on Backup Center is the jobs chart. Now, this gives you a quick snapshot of all the jobs that have run over the last 24 hours. You can further click view all and get more details on them as well. Another thing you'll notice almost instantly is the backup instances covered. This is a quick summary of all your backup instances of your chosen data source type. You can further drill down by simply clicking on it. And you'll see all your protected instances. You can take various actions by simply clicking on the ellipses. Now, one thing you'll notice in all these views is you have a lot of filter options available on the top. In fact, you have a new filter for tags also. An important thing to note over here is that all these filters, they work on the data source itself. So you don't need to worry about what vault your data source is being backed up, and your data source is your actual resource or your workload that you're protecting. Backup setter is not just great for monitoring, but it's your actual one stop for all your actions as well. For example, you can easily use it to start configuring backup, initiate restores, add policies and vaults as well. Let me quickly show you how to configure backup and how easy it is to configure backup. Just start by choosing a data source. I'm choosing the PostgreSQL server because that's the latest addition to the family of supported workloads. Next, I'm asked to choose a vault. Let me quickly search for my vault using the search bar. There it is. Simply select it. Now, the next thing I'm asked to choose is the backup policy, which governs how frequently my backups will occur and how long my backup data will be retained for. Let me go ahead and choose my production policy, which gives me 5 years of retention. Then I'm asked to choose what I'm supposed to protect. I can choose multiple databases across various servers. Let me go ahead and choose the databases that I want to protect. Now we do a quick round of validations. At this point, we try to validate if the vault that you have chosen has the right set of permissions to access the databases or not. And it's important to note here, we do not store any credentials anywhere. In fact, we use a highly secure AAD supported method for doing so. Once done, just click next and you can configure backup just like that. Simple, right? And equally simple, if not simpler, is to initiate restores and add policies and vaults. Now, an important part of being able to manage at scale is to be able to govern at scale. And Backup Center makes it tremendously easy for you to do that as well. You can use Azure policies and apply them at your chosen scope to perform various actions like audit or deploy. I have various policies over here. And once I apply these policies, I can use the backup compliance view to see how well I'm adhering to these. An important resource over here is the protectable data sources tab. Now this view gives me a list of all those data sources that are not configured for being backed up. So let me go and check if all my production servers are being backed up or not. I use a production tab on all of my servers, which I'll go and check. There are some 5 servers that ought to be protected but are not being backed up right now. They're not configured for backup right now, and I can get more details out of them right from here. In fact, if I'm using virtual machines and if I'm viewing these details for virtual machines, I can go ahead and configure backup right from here. I noticed some of my machines over here, they're SQL machines and Oracle machines. Now, with the new app consistency framework, I can actually use backup to perform app consistent backups as well for these machines. Another great thing that Backup Center helps you do is to be able to track your usage of backups and analyze your backup patterns. This is where backup reports come in extremely handy. Backup reports can give you key insights and analysis at various levels of granularity. Let me quickly choose a workspace for myself. This is the workspace that I have, and then I can get started. One new thing you'll notice in backup reports is the Optimize tab. The Optimize tab gives you opportunity to optimize your backup usage in several ways. One of the ways is to find out what are your inactive resources. An inactive resource is one of those resources that has been configured for backup but has not registered a successful backup over a specified period of time, which is 7 days in this case. Similarly, you can optimize your policy usage as well. You get options to optimize your retention as well as your schedule. Let me quickly show you what backup schedule optimization means. Right now, I see I have several databases that are configured for daily full backups. Maybe I don't need daily full backups, and maybe I'm better off with weekly full backups and daily differential backups, and that might translate into some cost savings for me. So Backup Center in similar ways gives you insights and analyzes your usage and suggests things to do that can result in your optimizations and in turn cost savings as well. So in short, we see that Backup Center is that single pane of glass that lets you monitor, operate, govern, as well as gather insights on your backup usage. So that was a quick tour of Backup Center for you. Do check out Backup Center yourself at ak.ms/Azure Backup Center. So here is a quick summary of everything that we discussed. And you would have noticed, Azure Backup continues to strengthen all its pillars. In addition to various product updates and announcements that we talked about, we also encourage you to try out the new advanced pricing calculator. In case if you're interested in signing up for any previews, feel free to write to us at askazurebackupteam@microsoft.com. Here's some great resources that you might want to look at. We also have a related session coming up called Minimize Business Disruption with Backup and Disaster Recovery on Azure. Here we talk about some great security and resiliency content from both backup and site recovery that can help you meet your BCDR objectives. Also, feel free to let us know about any features that you would like us to consider. And for these or anything else, you can always write to us at askazurebackupteam@microsoft.com. So this is it from my end for now. I hope you enjoyed it. Do let us know what you think about it. Thank you and have a good day.